Now let's move on to another area in the study of social psychology and social behavior, and that is the unfortunate bias of prejudice and resulting discrimination. Prejudice is a biased attitude toward a group of people or an individual member of a group based on unfair generalizations about what members of that group are like. Such prejudicial thinking is often the result of stereotypes instead of resulting from a careful observation of people's behavior. If we have a prejudice that is based on race or ethnicity, we call that racism. Or if we have a prejudice based on the sexes, we call that sexism. There is a lot of very interesting research, especially in the area of industrial organizational psychology, that looks at both prejudice and discrimination. So remember that prejudice is a biased attitude, but when that attitude changes to behavior, we see that discrimination can occur. Discrimination is a preferential treatment of certain people, usually driven by prejudicial attitudes. Psychologists have suggested that prejudice operates both inside and outside of our awareness. That is, we may be aware of our prejudice, but we may also hold a prejudicial view without being aware of it. Now, how do we know this, and how can we measure it? Two researchers, Benage and Greenwald, suspected that there was a disconnect between people's conscious and unconscious views of prejudice, and they developed a very interesting way to measure this. Go to the link below in the instructor's notes section and take the test for racism.